Look, Ma, it's a tape player from 1969. Let's play a tape. No, no, no. This is a compact cassette player from 1969. This is the Panasonic FM-AM stereo cassette player, the RS-280S. It works much like an 8-track, in that to play a tape, you just shove it in. And to stop and eject, you press stop. There are also buttons for rewind, fast forward, and record. I ended up replacing 5 belts and renewing 3 rubber tires in order to get the cassette player to work again. I also cleaned and lubricated moving parts such as the capstan bearing and the tape counter mechanism, which had become frozen due to its old lubrication turning sticky. Let's turn it on. And we can look at some of these other controls. Here we've got tone and volume for the left speaker, volume and tone for the right speaker. We have a switch to choose from stereo and mono. And we also have AFC on and off. There's 2 VU meters. And there's 5 indicators here to tell you what your input is, whether it is phono, tape, FM, FM stereo, or AM. Of course, there's the tuning wheel and a headphone jack. And also, as a part of the cassette player, there is a tape counter here. So let's play a tape, and I'm going to tune to the input of tape, and I'll go ahead and insert this tape. A little Sound of Music here. So to stop and eject the tape, you just press stop. Okay, here's the backside of the Panasonic RS-280S. This is with the back panel removed. The compact cassette mechanism is here. There's not a whole lot to see. And to get to the belts, there is quite a bit of disassembly, which I did do, and I did replace all the belts. The unit has its jacks here. You've got your microphone, aux in, phono, line out, and then external speaker, and you can choose to turn off the external speaker. You've got the antenna there. When I first got this unit, I couldn't easily tune to a station. It felt like the tuning string, the dial string, was bound up. What I found was, when I took this apart, the nylon wheel that makes contact with the metal gear that is connected to the tuner itself, that the nylon wheel was stripped a bit. I was able to reposition the nylon wheel over the metal gears to make better contact, but of course, I snapped the dial string in the process. So I ended up threading all new dial string, which took quite a while to get right. The good news is now that I do have a functioning AM/FM tuner.
In the top 5, and just, he has injuries.
10/99 Tuesday, so.
Light of hand and twist of face on a bed of nails.
What I find in a lot of these grace teachers is while they can keep
33995 GOLD.